2nd September 2021 Today, explain to you about the purpose in the practice. The purpose is not, breathing is not purpose. Okay? But the knowing breathing is a purpose. And then you don't have to try to strongly focus your breath and in breath. Don't have to. You just see, you just know now breathing in, you just know now breathing out. Why? Because in this way you got awareness of some thought, some feeling. And if you got awareness of whatever happening, thought or feeling or whatever sensation, and by keep knowing your breathing, you keep knowing your breathing in, keep knowing your breathing out, even you got a bit thought, you just awareness a bit thought. You got sensation here, don't let your breathing. Keep awareness of sensation here. Because when you got awareness of whatever arising, disappearing, it will make your knowing become good knowing. Because you can know breathing and also things together. So don't fight with thought. Even you got thought, you knowing thought, and you still knowing breathing or not? You still knowing breathing, but thought come, you know thought together. And thought, when you know thought, thought gone, you just know thought, thought gone, no thought. And then you keep knowing breathing. That means breathing is form, or rupa. But what arising is nama, abstract. Nama mean my sensation, mental quality, thought, or whatever phenomena is my. So vipassana, we keep knowing both together, breathing and mind. Okay. So you only keep knowing breathing, but how about, can you get awareness of sensation? What sensation? Less thought, more thought, desire, or some heaviness, or some attachment, or some lightness. You must get awareness of all phenomena, good or bad. Okay? And not let your breathing. In this way, knowing is the main purpose. We start knowing breathing, but whatever mala, kilesa, thought try to overcome you, and you just aware. Okay? When you just aware, then your knowing become clearer knowing, both form and nama. Okay? Because I found from my experience in this way. When I was young, about 20 years old, I just know my breathing. And I know all feeling together. But I not left my breathing. I know my breathing. And awareness of all feeling together. Then I got intuitive, clear knowing. Wake up, because I know both nama and rupa. Then I got clear knowing wake up. Okay. If in this way, you happy. Today is so much thinking. Never mind. You must know breathing and so much thinking. Okay. Or it become less thinking. Never mind. Don't happy. Just know less thinking and no breathing together. Oh, no thought, very calm. Don't be too much happy. You must know waiting and calmness together, because you must know nama and rupa together. So today we develop vipassana, knowing nama and rupa. Now, can you know my talk? Because you listen to me, and can you know your feeling? Get it? You must know your feeling together. Then you got knower inside wake up. Knower, not wake up, because you know only extremely concentration on the rupa, on the object, but you cannot know clearly nama together. So if you can know both nama, rupa, rupa, and nama, rupa, and nama, and you play football, knowing together, knowing become knower, wake up. So now you look at me, and you know you are yourself, you are sitting, and you are feeling. Okay. And if you look at your breath or breathing, never mind, breath or breathing. But how about nama, that moment? Nama or all phenomena we call nama, you know? All phenomena is nama. But you got misconcept. Try to get over all phenomena. Get over all kilesa. Don't try to get over. What kilesa arising, just know. And then it disappear. And then just know. And just know means you must keep knowing breathing as primary object, and then just aware of whatever kilesa arising, whatever kilesa disappear, and keep knowing your breathing, and keep awareness of sensation here, sensation here, sensation here, sensation here, awareness together. Then it will good benefit to you, got clear knowing, wake up. But if you try to fight, wow, too much tight, too much. Then you try to keep focus breathing. Then your mind feel really tight as well. But if you accept, okay, whatever sensation arising, you aware together, aware. Then you can see sensation, anicca sensation, dukkhang sensation, anatta sensation, change. Okay. So now today we develop knowing. We not build up breathing, okay? Same. If you chanting Buddha, the main purpose is not Buddha. The main purpose is the one who know Buddha. You know Buddha only. You got samatha. But today you must know Buddha and know all arising disappearing together. Buddha and know all feeling arising together, all phenomena arising together, and no arising and disappearing. When you know arising, it disappearing. Okay. So today, don't try to get over your kilesa. Don't try to get over your thoughts. Just aware, but keep knowing breathing as primary object. All other feeling awareness together. You must aware really quickly. Then it will help your knowing breathing become knowing Buddha nature, clear knowing, because you accept whatever arising, oh, your kilesa, accept. And then accept, then don't let your breathing, okay? Don't let your breathing. Try. Now open eye first. Know your breathing, you know? And how about you know any feeling or not? Yeah, okay. But if you too much concentration, you cannot know any other feeling. So that is samatha. Vipassana, we must properly know breathing and know feeling, because vipassana, the main purpose is knowing both together. Nama and rupa, rupa and nama. Breathing is rupa. Okay? You understand? Today, new approach. Because you don't know the purpose. Purpose is good knowing, whatever arising, disappearing, good knowing. How to get to develop good knowing? not go out with all whatever. Normally, whatever arising, you look, then you forget your breathing. Whatever arising, you watch, then you forget your breathing. You make mistake. Okay. Okay. Mala come, desire come, you look your mind, you forget your breathing. So only just aware. Kilesa, mala, desire, thought, less thought, but not left your breathing. Okay. And this thing, when you awareness, immediately awareness, immediately whatever arising, if you support your knowing, breathing become clear knowing much better. It will support. You know your thought? Immediately, thought come immediately, you know your thought and you know your breathing. Knowing your thought and you know immediately, it will make your knowing become good knowing. And then you know thought, sometimes bit thought, less thought, more thought, very good. But you must know your breathing together. When you know your breathing together, thought become less, 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 and you know less thought or not. If you know less thought, you are knowing, become knowing clearly, clearly knowing. Okay? Okay, you know your breathing, you cause pain or not? Good. No awareness of pain, but not look at pain. Just awareness of pain. You understand? When you awareness of pain, it will support your knowing breathing more stable. Okay? You got itchiness or not? Don't look. Don't watch. Just aware. If you look at itchiness, then you forget knowing your breathing. Okay? You know, whatever coming as sensation, itchiness, or whatever, knowing together with your breathing, then your knowing become good knowing. Okay? Try. I let's say today I teach you do meditation by wisdom. By wisdom. Don't only boxing, fighting. No, not good. By wisdom. Okay? Now, knowing your breathing. You know or not? And you awareness of bodily movement or not? Because you not close your eye. Maybe you got this way, see this way. Very good. You just aware of movement together. Then awareness of movement will support your knowing breathing. Okay? Knowing breathing with awareness of all phenomena together. This is nobody teaching me. I practice this way when I was about 20 years old. I knowing breathing and I know all feeling together. But I don't think it really good. I think it's simple. I know breathing and know feeling together. Even I was 20 years old, 21st year old, I don't think it any difficult, okay? But I don't know it's really important. I don't know it's really important. But today I tell you it's really important knowing nama and rupa together. Rupa you know already, knowing breathing. And nama, you still alive or not? You're not dead. Then you got nama. Okay. Now knowing breathing, you know breathing is a nama, is a rupa. And whatever feeling, awareness together. Knowing breathing nicely. Don't try too much focus your breath. Otherwise, you cannot know other nama or feeling. Then you got stuck, okay? Now, just know, the Buddha know, say no, clearly breathing in, no, clearly breathing out, okay? And in Vedana Nupassana, Citta Nupassana, and Dhamma Nupassana, the Buddha say, and knowing sensation, knowing my activity, knowing all phenomena of Dhamma quality together with knowing, breathing in, with knowing, breathing out. So knowing, breathing in and out is a primary object. And you must know other things together. Other thing that is nama or my activity or sensation. Now I know my breathing, and then I get knowing sensation together. More calmness than you know breathing only. More. Okay, because you accept everything in me. And it looks like the calmness with equanimity of mind. Okay. Okay, we do it now. Open eye. Because otherwise you close your eye, you try to focus breathing and forget knowing nama. Nama or feeling. Or abstract feeling. Fire. You know your breathing and you know any subtle nama, subtle feeling, subtle sensation, you must be able to know with awareness or awareness together of all sensation. Awareness will support your knowing with. Okay. Even got thought, very good. Awareness of thought. And even thought disappear, awareness of thought disappear. Then your knowing become clear knowing, become more aware. The purpose is to develop knowing. Breathing not the purpose. Buddha not the purpose. But the one who know breathing and the Buddha is the purpose. Get to know breathing. Can you know into any Dhamma, any phenomena, any feeling, any kilesa together? Can you know breathing and know kilesa together? Can you? When you know kilesa, you're knowing wake up, then kilesa. Release, okay? And wake up with knowing more clearly, really. You know breathing, can you know your smile together? Okay? No breathing and no all other feeling at the moment, okay? And close your eyes. Thought coming. Thank you, thought. Awareness of thought. Okay. Knowing, breathing, and awareness of thought together. Thank you, thought. and thought become less thought, knowing less thought, knowing breathing and awareness of less thought. Awareness of thought, awareness of less thought will benefit your knowing. If you knowing breathing but you don't have any awareness of anything arising at that moment, that means you are knowing poor quality. Okay, poor quality. If you are knowing good quality, you must be able knowing with awareness of all any formation of mind together with knowing breathing. Okay, very challenging. Knowing breathing and awareness of all thought and feeling together, and all thought, feeling, and sensation together. Okay, and very quickly, don't try to look at thought, look at sensation, watch or notice your thought. No. Just very quickly awareness and keep knowing your breathing, and it quickly go by itself. Quickly come, quickly go. Quickly come, quickly go. Because you got knowing breathing as primary object. When you close your eye, when you know your breathing, a lot that you get awareness, a lot. That is, sometimes you got sensation, sometimes you got thought, sometimes you got numb, sometimes you got whatever feeling. Quickly come, quickly go, okay? And maintain knowing your breathing, not lost. Or you know your breathing, you got awareness of stomach movement, good. Knowing breathing and awareness of stomach arising and disappearing. So you know breathing as primary object, and knowing all other together at that moment. Before you know something else, then you forget breathing. Now you cross the stream, you go stream entry. It looks like you go stream entry. Whatever feeling, thought, or phenomena cannot block you. Okay? Cannot block you because you keep knowing, breathing as primary object. Whatever phenomena cannot block your knowing. Then your knowing got good quality because your knowing got awareness of all phenomena together. Very good quality. That is the quality of vipassana. Now it looks like you are very good player. You know reading and very good player. Any come to overcome you, you just keep aware. Very good player, keep aware. Just keep aware and don't let your breathing. Whatever come up to you, you just aware. And it quickly come, quickly gone. And it will support your knowing because quickly come, quickly gone, you're not attached. That means you're not attached. You only aware. Then you're not attached, you got good awareness. You are knowing, breathing, more clear knowing now. Even you go deep in meditative state, still got all subtle feelings. You must know breathing as primary object. Okay? Today we use the word knowing, as the Buddha say in Anapanasati Sutta, knowing breathing in, knowing breathing out. We don't use the word to wash your breathing. That is not the Buddha say. If you wash your breathing, then it difficult to awareness of something together, okay? Or you just see breathing, knowing breathing, seeing breathing. If you still get used to watch your breathing, that's okay, but not too much concentration. Can watch mindfully and with awareness. Okay, you can watch, but not too much concentration. Okay, watch mindful with mindful awareness of some other thing together. Can you? Okay, you understand now? Watch with mindful awareness of some other arising, disappearing at that moment. Can you? If you put too much concentration, you cannot get awareness of anything. You only try to forget your breathing and you get stillness and only samatha, cannot go to vipassana. But anyhow, it's still good. Next time, maybe you develop vipassana. But today, we learn new approach. Okay? More vipassana. Samatha is good, not bad, okay? But today, we develop vipassana. When we learn, start learning vipassana, knowing breathing, I recommend you knowing breathing. Don't have to watch to look at your breathing because you not get used to aware, to be aware of some other thing. So today, knowing and aware. But when you got awareness, wake up already, then you can watch. Then you can watch your breathing mindfully because you got awareness already. But today you don't have awareness of all other phenomena. You don't have. If you start to develop awareness, then knowing and awareness in the practice, when you got skill, then you can watch and aware, okay? And knowing mindfully and aware. Now we start to learn how to know breathing as the main object and awareness of all phenomena, all phenomena together. Then only know breathing and keep knowing with awareness of some other things together. thought coming, knowing thought with awareness of thought together. Knowing breathing and awareness of thought together. You must develop quick awareness. Okay. Knowing breathing and quick awareness. Instant awareness. Can you? In this way, you will see anicjang anatta, tukkhang anatta. Arising and disappearing. Quick awareness and quick letting go. Quick awareness, quick letting go. Always knowing your breathing. Then we'll help you quick awareness, quick letting go. And now opening eye, you can know breathing and awareness of whatever feeling and thought together very easily. And you can stay in between. This way you got equanimity of mind, knowing breathing and awareness of any other feeling and any thought together. Can you? And your knowing become equanimity of mind more and more. And and equality of mind with good quality knowing. More you awareness quickly awareness and quickly letting go any feeling and thought, your knowing become bright, clear knowing. Okay, so now you have a lot of exercise, knowing, breathing, and awareness of all phenomena together, and quickly aware and quick letting go. Okay, now for the eye. Then your knowing stay in between. This is going to equanimity of mind. You go direct to equanimity of mind in this way, knowing, breathing, and awareness of all other feeling or even thought together with quick awareness, instant awareness. Instant awareness every moment. And you can see you got more clear knowing. And your knowing reading become clearer and clearer. You can see from your experience today. Knowing with mindful awareness of all phenomena together. Doesn't matter mindful awareness of body foundation or mindful awareness of sensation foundation, mind foundation or Dhamma foundation. Mindful awareness together with knowing breathing as primary object. And it will be brighten your knowing clearly. Clearly with seeing, you first can see clear knowing. Before you never see clear knowing of your mind. You see breathing, but today you see clear knowing. When you can see clear knowing, then you can see knowing of what? Of breathing, then you can see breathing clearly as well. Seeing clearly, clear knowing in your mind, and seeing breathing clearly as well. Knowing, breathing with awareness of all together. Okay. Make it short. You understand already. Awareness of all together at that moment. Awareness of all together. Just quick awareness, instant awareness, together with knowing really. So sometimes you can realize your awareness. Sometimes God realizes from awareness. Realize body foundation, sometimes realize sensation foundation, sometimes realize mind foundation, sometimes realize mental quality foundation. Doesn't matter. Awareness of all together. Or we can say knowing breathing with intuitive awareness of all together. This is intuitive awareness. Today we do have intuitive awareness, that is wisdom, wisdom eye. You see from intuitive awareness, see the four foundations. Sometimes you see body foundation, pain or tired. Sometimes you see sensation foundation. Sometimes you see thought or mind sankhara foundation. Or sometimes you see mental quality foundation. We develop in vipassana the intuitive awareness in this way. But we need samatha by knowing clearly breathing. But together with intuitive awareness of all together. you got seeing from intuitive awareness. That is the mind. So train your mind, wake up with intuitive awareness, seeing all together. That is the mind. And it's seeing inverse. Seeing stream entry inverse with intuitive awareness. That is, you see, rising, falling from intuitive awareness. What you see from intuitive awareness is rising, falling, or arising and disappearing. More intuitive awareness will make your knowing clearly, being clearer, more clearly, much more clearly, because you got very good intuitive awareness. That is, you got knowing more clearly, breathing more inside as well. Or you can know breathing clearly, more the whole breathing as well, with intuitive awareness. You are knowing very good quality of knowing. Knowing all, or knowing the whole breathing together. Even opening eye remain the same, knowing, breathing clearly with intuitive awareness of all feeling together. Can you? Intuitive awareness, knowing awareness, intuitive awareness, what arising, disappearing, you see by intuitive awareness. Thank you. And even you open eye, you can know your breathing clearly with intuitive awareness of all mental states. Can you? And not involved. And knowing in between. Knowing, breathing with awareness of all mental states. Arising, disappearing, and not involved. Knowing by intuitive awareness. And close your eye again. Intuitive awareness, that is enlightenment factor. Wake up. Enlightenment factor wake up. And more wake up, it becomes Dhamma eye. Enlightenment factor. And opening eye again. In the beginning, practice both closing eye and opening eye. Opening eye will help bring more wake up. When you close your eye, then you get more wake up. When you opening eye, intuitive awareness, also awareness of body foundation, stomach movement as well. That's right. And now intuitive awareness, more awareness of stomach, body sensation, arising, disappear, rising, falling, and sensation rising, falling, arising and disappearing, arising, disappearing deep into the mental state. So that's why in the whole day, you only develop knowing your breathing as home with intuitive awareness of the four foundations. Okay? You're sitting. You just keep knowing, breathing as home. And together, you develop intuitive awareness of the four foundation, body, how body, you can see rising, falling, how sensation, you can see the flow of your sensation of the body and of your mind. Okay? And keep knowing, breathing, and develop intuitive awareness more and more, then it got intuitive awareness of even thought. Release, no thought, even desire, release. And then you just more exercise into satipatthana with intuitive awareness, the great mindfulness, the real mindfulness. Your mindfulness from awareness. You create mindfulness from awareness. Before you don't have good awareness, you try to be mindful. But this is mindfulness from awareness. You develop intuitive awareness, then you got mindfulness from awareness. We call great mindfulness, no self, without self. And it will explore. Great mindfulness will explore body rising, falling, sensation of thought or feeling or emotion or desire or attachment with letting go. And then it turn over and it go more enlightenment factor with intuitive awareness, exploring, investigation into the Dhamma. And you already keep knowing breathing as home. And the whole day you develop intuitive awareness, you got satipatthan the whole day, the four foundation the whole day. Until more you, the whole day, instead of maybe only practice only evening time, not the whole day. More the whole day, then you can see this body not you, sensation not you, body not you, mental quality not you, desire not yours, okay, attachment not your, okay, because you keep knowing breathing as home and develop intuitive awareness. Intuitive awareness will explore the whole four foundations. Sometimes explore body foundation. Wow, it's only five aggregate of four elements. Sometimes explore sensation foundation. Sometimes explore mind foundation or whatever mental state foundation. Oh, you got satipatthan to learn to let go. Learn to let go everything with intuitive awareness according to satipatthan 4. Knowing your breathing as home. Even you walk, you knowing your breathing as home, intuitive awareness, seeing this person like a robot. Walking, sometimes walking fast, sometimes walking slowly, sometimes walking hurriedly, sometimes walking this way. You see my intuitive awareness. So this is Dhamma eye. And close your eye again. And see my intuitive awareness. And now just review your understanding about intuitive awareness together with knowing, breathing every moment. Knowing, breathing every moment with intuitive awareness, wake up more and more. Very quiet in seclusion because with intuitive awareness, more wake up, more seclusion. Quiet. Know you, know your body, see the way it is, know the way it is beautifully, and letting go. And now share mercy to everybody in your family and everybody in your country with loving kindness and compassion. With smiling to yourself for your good health, happiness and all success. And we finish today's session. Now chanting together and knowing your breathing as home and see your chanting from intuitive awareness. Okay. Buddhang saranang kacchami. Dhammang saranang kacchami. Sanghang saranang kacchami. May the Buddha, Dhamma, and Sangha protect you and your family with good health and all well-being with Dhamma in this very life. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu.